of the visitation. Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and cried out with a loud voice, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb." The fruit of this mystery is love of you. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Fourth joyful mystery is the presentation of Jesus in the temple. When the day came to purify them according to the law of Moses, the couple brought him up to Jerusalem so that he could be presented to the Lord. Every firstborn male will be consecrated to the Lord. The fruit of this mystery is obedience. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Fifth joyful mystery, the finding of the child Jesus in the temple. On the day they came upon him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. The fruit of this mystery is greater commitment and devotion to Jesus. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, give us our sins, forgive us our crimes, heal all souls who have need, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee we cry, poor finished children gave. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning, weeping, and this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, thy knives and mercy towards us. And now commence our exile, come to us, was the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, beloved, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, the Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises.
Let us pray. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech thee, that meditating upon these mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, that we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through the same Christ our Lord. Let us pray. O Mary, bright dawn of the new world, mother of the living, to you do we entrust the cause of life. Look down, O Mother, upon the vast numbers of babies not allowed to be born, of the poor whose lives are made difficult, of the men and women who are victims of brutal violence, of the elderly and the sick, killed by indifference or out of misguided mercy. Grant that all who believe in your Son may proclaim the gospel of life with honesty and love to the people of our time. Obtain for them the grace to accept the gospel as a gift ever new, the joy of celebrating it with gratitude throughout their lives, and the courage to bear witness to it resolutely, in order to build, together with all the people of goodwill, the civilization of love and truth to the praise and glory of God, the Creator and Lover of life. And this we ask in Jesus' holy name.
just a note that you can find the program with the music for this evening's Mass in the center aisle and also in the transept entrances. You can also find the music on the homepage of the cathedral website at holycrossgospel.com. Click the button that says Solemnity of Mary at holycrossgospel.com. As you can see, there's a table in the center aisle.
Peace be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me for the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
The Lord said to Moses, speak to Aaron and his sons, and tell them this is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them. The word of the Lord. Second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we may receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son, and if a son, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Found Mary and Joseph, and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told to them about this child. All who heard it were amazed at what had been told to them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, a very blessed New Year to all of you and your loved ones. I was reading tonight that Times Square is having a scaled-back celebration, but we are very pleased that you have joined us here tonight so that we can begin the new year praising God and asking for his blessing on our lives and on our world. Thank you for being here for the first night to go to Bethlehem with the shepherds to congratulate the new mother. At Christmas, when I was a child, my dad used to get the Christmas tree on Christmas Eve. Of course, by then, most of the trees were very picked over, and so he would have to buy two or three of these scraggly trees. And then he would come to his workshop, take branches off of some of the trees, and insert them in the holes that he drilled into a tree to fill out this beautiful tree. And in the morning, when we would come down, that we would be amazed because this tree appeared out of nowhere in the middle of the night. That amazement is the amazement that the shepherds felt when they went to Bethlehem, when they heard the message of the angel. All of those who heard the message were amazed. I think my dad wanted us to have that amazement. And we're here tonight asking for the Lord's gift, the grace, to feel that amazement once again in our own lives, our amazement that our God has come into our history. We calculate the year from the moment of his birth, and yet all of this has become lost in time. And so, like Mary, we want to reflect on the meaning of all of this. When I was in the seminary, our provincial wrote to Rome and he said, "Our missions are flourishing. We would like to start a new mission. Please send our friars to the most difficult mission in the world." And a week later, we got a letter back from Rome telling the provincial to open a mission in Papua New Guinea. Papua New Guinea is a very isolated place. There's over 500 languages there. The people are so isolated that they're very, very primitive. And when our friars arrived there, they landed in a plane, and the natives came out of the bush, and the interpreter asked, they wanted to know if the plane was a male or a female. They said if it was a female, they wanted an egg. For them, everything was new, and particularly the gospel. and the arrival of the gospel changed their lives so much. A couple of years ago, we celebrated the 50th anniversary of the arrival of the gospel to that part of the world. The people came together with such joy, and they talked about the liberation that the gospel brought into their lives. How before the gospel was preached, they were practicing cannibalism, they were in constant tribal wars, they lived in darkness and fear. And suddenly the light of Christ was brought into their lives, and the gospel liberated them and gave them a new joy and a new reason to live. It was a very interesting article this week in the New York Times, where the writer is reflecting on the impact that Christmas made on Western civilization. And the thesis of the article is that Christmas has shaped our worldview in the Western world, even among those who do not believe in Jesus Christ. But that the Western world is so saturated in Christian assumptions that it's almost impossible to remove them. The Christian Revolution remade the world, as one British historian said. In the Western world, we've taken for granted that the lowest of the lowest have dignity. Before this revolution of Christ's birth, nearly all the ancient societies had a caste system. Jesus was born in a Roman world where might made right. To be a slave or a woman or have a disability or be of a racial or religious minority was to lack dignity and value. But the story of Jesus represents a whole new way of being human and seeing humanity. Christ's birth has brought dignity to all. Suddenly, we're all relatives of the King who came in poverty and simplicity to an oppressed people and a religious minority. The value of the weak is more important than the prerogatives of the powerful. Because of this, the early Christians became known for rescuing and raising infant children who were exposed to the elements, left out to die, which was a common practice in the ancient world. The radical recognition of the dignity of each and every human being is part of the glad tidings of Christmas. This year, we're praying very hard that the protection of human life will be a reality for the Supreme Court poised to decide on Dobbs case and how that will impact Roe versus Wade. In the United States, there was an activist Supreme Court that decided that Americans have a right to end the life of an unborn child. 50 years have passed. But the influence of a Christian culture born out of Christ's birth at Bethlehem still echoes through the conscience of America, and people are uneasy to justify the indiscriminate extermination of human life in the womb. On this feast of the maternity of Mary, and with our eyes fixed on Bethlehem, we realize that the message is that the Lord God reveals his love in the face of a little child. Because God's love is never old, never stale. God's love is always new, is always fresh. God never tires of loving us, never tires of forgiving us, never tires of giving us a second chance. And he's come to us in poverty and obscurity to show us the treasure his love and the treasure of human life. The message is that every human being is precious in God's sight, and is worthy even when life seems inconvenient. Ultimately, the solution to the plague of abortion will be solidarity and community, a society that cares for the weakest and the most vulnerable, a society that will not abandon the expectant mother in her hour of need. The pro-life cause is about working to change legislation to protect the unborn, but it's also about changing hearts, finding other solutions for a difficult pregnancy and an inconvenient birth. One of our priests here in Boston was adopted. Recently, he found his birth mother. In this last year, actually, his birth mother and his adoptive mother both died. But he told me that the mother who raised him, who was so dear to him, said to him before he died, "I want to meet your birth mother." And he said, "Why?" He said, "I just want to say thank you to her." And around the very same time, his biological mother, who was also dying, said to him, "I want to meet your mom, the one who raised you." And when he said, "Why?" she said, "I just want to say thank you to her." Recently, Justice Amy Coney Barrett urged adoption over abortion, and there was quite a pushback from many of the pro-abortionists. We need, certainly, to do more to promote adoption, to make it more user-friendly, more humane. Once again, the solution is always going to be solidarity and community. I have been going to the pro-life marches since the beginning, the first one. It was 50 years ago. And right from the beginning, I've always said, I hope that I won't have to do this the rest of my life. And so at this point, I'm hoping perhaps this is the year. Maybe it would be the end of Roe versus Wade. Our prayer tonight is through the Mother of Mary that there will be a change in our country. But just as urgently, perhaps more so, a change of heart, that we can have that solidarity and sense of community that will allow us to bring about a society that cares for everyone. Unfortunately, at this moment in our history, we seem so divided about everything. We're fighting about everything, politics, pandemic, you name it. But we can be apostles of life by bearing witness to the gospel, by being coherent in the way that we live our Christian life. And people will believe us if they know that we truly care about them. May this new year, 2022 AD, the year of the Lord, be the year of life, a new chance for love, a new chance to serve. Mary became our mother at the foot of the cross, where Jesus says, "Behold thy mother." Let us pray for greater unity in our country and in our church to achieve that solidarity and community that will allow us to care for all who are suffering and care for all, so that there will be room at the table of life, so that no child will be left behind, no life deemed inconvenient. Jesus came in a manger. Teach us to make room in the inn for every baby. Happy New Year. We have listened to God's word and reflected upon it. Let us now make our response by praying together our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. My dear friends, let us confidently make known our needs to our Heavenly Father, who always hears our prayer with tenderness and love.
For Pope Francis, Cardinal Seán, and the Church around the world, that the upcoming year 2022 will be a time of unity, reconciliation, and an end to the global COVID pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, we are praying.
For medical staff and first responders who have faithfully and courageously cared for patients throughout the COVID-19 pandemic, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, we are praying.
For peace throughout the world and peace in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, we are praying.
For respect for the dignity of human life to be cherished and protected at all stages, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the millions of people who have been displaced from their homes as a result of war, famine, and political instability, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, that they strive to follow the example of the Holy Family and live out their vocations with love as joyful witnesses to the gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Increasing vocations to religious life and priesthood, especially here in the Archdiocese of Boston, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all who have died over the past year, and for all who will die alone this night, that they will be welcomed into the eternal kingdom of God's unconditional love and mercy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And we offer all of our prayers confidently through the intercession of Mary of Bethlehem, the mother of the divine shepherd, as together we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, when your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to the earth's end, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the author of our salvation, your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim.
Remember also our brothers and sisters. spirits who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord. Go forth.